So right now we're in Hat Nopora Tara Beach, which is one of the most beautiful beaches here in Krabi. I'm not entirely sure if that's how you say it, but I had to give it a try.
It's a very long name for a beach, but I mean, it's absolutely beautiful here. It is a bit windy, so I hope you can hear us.
There's a lot of children playing, and what we like the most is that most of the people here are locals and there's not many tourists, so we just come here now and can actually swim all the way there to the island.
I think this is the best view we've seen in Ao Nang so far of the mountains. It's really good from here. By that rock there is Ao Nang Beach, and if you keep going all the way around these mountains, you would reach Railay Beach. So we haven't been there yet, but we're definitely going to be going soon. Really excited to see that. But this video isn't a beach video.
Today is a Saturday afternoon and we decided to have a massive feast. And can you guess which food is it going to be? You guessed it right, we're at the sea, so obviously it's seafood. See if we can find some seafood on the way. There's loads of little snails and someone just found like a massive starfish. And yeah, there's a lot of little living creatures here. Me and Olivia have been vegetarian for quite a while, so we never had a chance to actually try decent seafood here in Asia. So I think this is gonna be the first time.
About an hour later, we finally made it back to the, the beachfront.
In 5 minutes.
It's really far away. Yeah, this area has beautiful big trees, lots of people just sitting and eating their lunch here. It's really nice, right?
Yep. Talking about lunch, I mean, we're way past lunch now. It's about 3 or 4 in the afternoon. So let's go and devour some seafood.
It gets pretty busy here.
Yeah, this is one of the busiest areas of Ao Nang because that's where you take the boat to the islands, like Olivia just said.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of like local tourists coming down. But this is where we are going.
This is the restaurant.
Yeah, Kra Tara. Looked online for several places and this seems like the most suitable for us. And the most quiet one as well, apparently. So let's go check it out.
Kavatika. So we are probably gonna sit out here because it just looks really cute. Okay, Kapunka. Flicking through the menu here. It's really beautiful. The photos are really nicely done, but honestly, I have no idea about anything apart from like fish and prawns. So I think Mario's gonna have to order for both of us and decide what we're gonna have. What are we gonna have, Mario?
So I was just looking at this ocean basket that comes with a lot of stuff. Like there's like 3 different crabs, fish, all kinds of clams and shells and king prawns, but as the lady, she said it's for 4 to 5 people, and yeah, it's a bit too much for us.
Yeah.
So we don't want to be wasting any food because that's not what we do. We just hate doing that. So we're just gonna try and order a bit of everything to try a little bit of that exotic food because we've been eating so boring lately. A lot of fried rice and burgers, boring. So yeah, we're going all the way in with the seafood. So some of the foods already arrived pretty fast actually, and we got some stir-fried clams with garlic. And we have, I don't even know the name of,
but this yellow steamed conch.
Yeah, yellow steamed conch. Basically, I remember finding this one in the sea and I would just take it back home. But now we're just gonna eat those.
Is that the one that you can hear the sound
sea in? Something like that. Okay. So I'm guessing we're using this stick like this and you just pull it out like that.
How is it?
Really good.
Is it spicy?
No, it's actually really nice and really soft flavor. I like it.
I think we've actually got more food.
We got some tamarind sauce prawns. King prawns, I think, because by the size of it, it looks pretty big. So yeah, it's
huge.
Definitely a king one. Wow. I love the tamarind sauce in here. Wow, it's so nice. Tamarind actually is one of our favorite fruits. And having this with the seafood, top notch.
Gonna start off with the green bean in the chili shrimp dip that we got. We got all kinds of veg to go with all the seafood. The lady, the chef, said that this was gonna be spicy for us, but it doesn't taste that spicy. It's not so bad. It's quite good. Unless you put less chili in on purpose. Right, should I give this a go?
Of course. That's what we've been waiting for. Olivia's trying her first clams in her life.
What do I do?
So you just take it and then suck it.
So just like drink it like that.
Just suck it all out. Right?
That's so easy.
So good.
Wow. With the garlic, I'm so glad we chose the garlic one. There was also one with chili and lime, which is more Thai, I guess, but the garlic is really good. Okay, now let's try the steamed yellow conch. I've never eaten anything out of a shell like this before. These are actually fresh from the Andaman Sea here in Krabi. The chef told us.
There, just behind us, yep, from so that sea over there.
Very local, very fresh. Do I just stab it?
Yeah, and just pull it out.
Come here.
Yeah, pull it all out.
Come on.
Whoa, yes. The tip might be a little bit hard, just like a prawn's tip.
So you don't eat that
Yeah,
bit.
You don't need that bit. Just hold on to that and then eat the rest. Go for it.
Yeah? Okay.
Can do it. It's supposed to be delicious. Because it's steamed, so it's not so chewy.
Whoa. It's definitely got a sea flavor to it.
Do you like it?
It's a strange texture. It's very like gooey, chewy. I think I got a bit of sand in there.
I think you just ate the shit of it at the bottom.
Are you serious?
But it's not a bad thing.
What do you mean the shit? Like it took a poo in the shell and I just ate it. You saw me eat that and you didn't tell me.
Okay, watch.
I think it's like dirt, yeah. It tastes really crunchy.
Yeah. So.
I think I ate it wrong.
There we go. Washed with some Singha. Not getting promoted by Singha yet.
Not yet.
So as you can see, the green stuff that Olivia ate stayed in the shell. So I don't think you're supposed to eat that. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna use a little bit of this sauce right here.
Oh, is that what you're supposed to do?
Yeah, the green, yeah. Amazing.
Oh my god. I've never eaten a crab that big. When we were in Laos, we tried river crab and it was like, they were like this big, tiny little crabs, right?
Yeah, they were like river crabs, absolutely tiny. And these are monsters compared to that. I mean, look at these babies. What? Whoa. So everything has arrived now. We have our crabs, our prawns, our shells. Everything is here. And now I'm gonna try the crab itself. There you go, that looks massive.
So what's that, his leg?
Yeah, like something like that. So then I'm assuming you just put it like this and it breaks very easily. You don't have to use any power. You don't have to use a hammer. Just use this thing and then it breaks like that. And this is all the crab meat inside.
Ah.
Mmm. Break it a bit more. Oh my god, tastes so good.
Use those muscles.
Mmm.
Good?
Mmm. Tastes so, so fancy.
Mmm.
Mmm.
Travels on toast?
Mm. Not for today. But damn, that feels so good. It's so meaty as well. There's so much crab meat. Mmm. There's nothing better than eating seafood right next to Andaman Sea. Yeah. So do you know how to use this? Yeah? It's pretty basic.
No.
Just crack it in few spots. And actually
like
do it.
Like all the way?
All the way. This is depending on the size. You might need to put it sideways.
Okay, you hold like this.
Yeah.
Like that,
there
yeah?
There you go. And then you can break it in half, literally.
Ah, it's spiky.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, that's
there you
clean,
go. Look
clean,
at that.
Clean
Look
shot.
Look at all that crab meat.
Wow. Yum. Okay, here we go. Let's try the crab. Mm. Wow.
Did you like it?
Yeah.
Fresh crab from Andaman Sea.
Oh wow, it literally melts in your mouth. It's so good. I want to have more. Let me figure these out.
So we can't stop but eating this crab. It's so good, but we got so many other things to try that we haven't yet, like this shrimp, for example.
So this is tamarind sauce on it. Wow, look at all that
meat. I think it's like, it's called king prawns, not shrimp.
King
it's
prawns, king prawn, yeah. Yeah.
How is it?
Wow. Looks the sauce is like Very so meaty. Sweet. It's really nice.
Tamarind sauce.
It tastes like a bit like honey as well at the same time.
Give it a like massive this. Bite.
There's so much meat on that. That's really good. Wow.
Wow, look at that massive shrimp. Prawn. King prawn? I don't know. Wow. So much meat. Wow, it's a lot of seafood.
Are we gonna be able to eat all this?
We might need to order some beer. So much.
They're called king prawns for a reason, right?
Oh yeah, it tastes kingish. You have no idea how much effort it's taken us to film this video, because all we want to do is just crack on eating, but with these hands, it's very hard to keep on passing the camera.
I'm holding the camera like this to film you.
But we are trying our best, guys, because it is the food video at the end of the day.
What was your favorite so far?
So far, I think I really love the crab, obviously. To be honest, everything tastes really good. I don't think there's anything on this table that I don't like. I really, really like everything that we ordered. It was a good order.
The one that I like the least is probably this one, but I think it's because I ate it wrong. I ate like all the poop from the bottom. And it was pretty like, it tasted like sandy. But this one was really good with the garlic and the crab. Definitely these two are my favorites.
Oh yeah, I love these.
Really good.
They go so easy. Because they're fried.
Seafood is actually
so damn good. Can't
so
get enough
to eat.
I also wonder, what are these?
Grapes.
Right? Looks like made out of plastic, but they're coming from the bottom of the ocean.
Like seafood grapes. What is it?
Yeah, it tastes like seafood.
Is it like eggs?
Some vegetation. Yeah.
Like a seaweed.
But with like little eggs. Try it. It's really good. Eat the whole thing.
Oh, it's so salty. It tastes like the sea.
Yeah.
It literally tastes like I just swallowed.
Tastes a bit like caviar as well.
Caviar?
Tastes a bit like caviar, yeah.
So I don't want to be too quick to judge. I'm going to give the steamed conch another try, but with the sauce this time, because I think because it's steamed, there isn't too much like flavor or sauce, so let's just.
I think you can pick it with your fingers. It's already out.
This is so alien to me. Oh, boom, boom, boom. Bit of spicy Thai sauce.
Make sure you don't eat the tip, because it's hard.
Ooh, spicy.
How is it? Better?
It's a lot better with the sauce.
And better that you didn't eat the guts as well.
Yeah. I think chili makes everything taste better. But, no, my pet, my Aroy?
Something like that. In Laos, usually it's Bopet Bosep, but we're here, we need to learn a new language. So we're about an hour in eating this. As you can see, this is not getting much smaller. Although it is a little bit, but not much. So there's loads of crab. You want some crab?
Sure, although I'm getting pretty full, guys. Mario's capable of eating way more than I am. And
even me, even myself, I can barely manage it now. But I guess we need to eat it faster, because I can see some flies landing on it.
Yeah, they're all descending.
Yeah, they're waiting for it. So we pretty much finished all of it, and you have no idea how bloated we're feeling. And this is all we got left now.
Just a few of the steamed conch, which apparently only exist in the south of Thailand, in the Andaman Sea, which is what the lady Nina over there told us.
So basically, Nina is a Thai lady. She came all the way from Phuket. You came from Phuket? Yep. And it's nice to know that the local people actually is saying that a lot of Thai people come to this restaurant. So it's not really necessarily like popular for Pharangs, which is foreigners. Most of the foreigners eat in like the front beaches restaurants, which is quite expensive, but that's really, really affordable. And I mean, for us who are traveling on budget, it's something that's really, really nice and affordable. So thank you so much, Nina, for this advice.
Okay. Appreciate it. I keep on your fan club.
Awesome.
Okay.
So I am so full right now, but Olivia is trying to be a hero and just finish off those, what are they called again?
Conches.
Conches. The conches that can only be found in Andaman Sea. She's doing it.
I don't know if I can do it.
There's only a few more left.
I feel a bit sick now from just overeating. I'm starting to get into the like napping mode.
You got it.
Yeah. Wow, it is much better when you squeeze the lime into the shell first.
Yeah. Mm. Told you. That's how we do it in Spain. Squeeze loads of lime into the shell. Tastes much better. Wow, what a feast. Something that we never do on Travels on Toast. The most expensive meal we've ever had in our food episodes.
Yeah, it's the first time I've even tried seafood, really, properly. So it was pretty fun, it was exciting. And you're all probably wondering, how much did all of this cost? So all together, for everything, the beers, the rice, the veg, the seafood, it was all 1,600 baht, around that price.
It's just under $50, and to be honest, if you're a budget traveler, of course, it's something you're probably not gonna do every day. But if you compare prices with Europe, this is an absolute bargain. I feel like this would cost you hundreds of dollars back in Europe. So at the end of the day, we've got some amazing meals, yeah. Really fresh, right from the Andaman Sea. And the best part is some of the things like the conches are only found in the Andaman Sea. So you can only find them here in the south of Thailand.
And we would definitely recommend this restaurant in particular,
yep.
Krua Thara, because it's really authentic Thai seafood.
100%.
Like, you're not gonna find this kind of food at the beachfront. And if you do, it's gonna be like double the price.
So sometimes you just pay for the beachfront seat. You're actually not even paying for the seafood. You're paying for the seat. So
for the view.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, although I can see
this. This is the sea right there. If you guys can see, it's just right there. It takes about 30 seconds to get there.
I mean, this is good enough for us. We're budget travelers and...
This is amazing. The most important about seafood is freshness. How fresh it is. And it was as fresh as it can be.
Yeah.
I mean, good thing that the crab wasn't jumping and hopping. We didn't need it that fresh, but it was really good enough and we really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
And we also hope that you enjoyed watching this video as well.
Yeah, if you did so, hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. And